Let's talk about COUNTIF and COUNTIFS. So on the sheet we have the sales for a firm, and beside the name of the sale, or beside the sale, we have the salespeople that are responsible for these sales. And here we have the billing date. Now, what we would like to do is we would like to count how many of these sales were billed before the 15th of July. So what we're going to do is we are going to go equals, and we're going to go count if, and now let's select the range. So the range we're going to select, it starts it at this cell, and we're going to press Control Shift down arrow, and that will select our entire range. And so now we're going to put in a comma here. Now we would like this to be less than or equal to the date. And so what we're going to do is we're going to put in quotation marks, less than or equal to, we're going to end the quotation marks, put a little space in here, and then we're going to select this date here. Now, we don't want the actual date, we want it to be less than the value of the date. So let's put in an and sign, before this, so that it's saying, give me the value of this date. And then we're going to put a closing bracket on this, and we'll have our result. And there we have 18 sales for every sales person here that has been billed before or equal to the 15th. So now we would like to add another piece of criteria onto our count function. So what we're going to do is we're going to select the cell next to the 18, and we're going to go equals and count ifs. And there you have ifs. And so then what we'll do is we will do our same criteria as we did for the last one. So we're going to select this range, and then we're going to put a comma, then we're going to put a quotation mark, and we're going to go less than or equal to, and then we're going to end the quotation marks, we're going to put space, and then we're going to select the date here. Once again, we want it to be the value of the date, so we're going to put the and sign in front of it. Okay, so that's our first criteria. So we're going to put a comma here. And now let's select the second range. We're going to select the range where the salespeople are, and we're going to put a comma in there, and we're going to select the name of the salesperson that we want, which is John. And so we're going to close our bracket, and we're going to press Enter. So here you see that with the count ifs, we have determined that 18 sales were made by John were billed before or equal to the 15th. So that is the count if and the count ifs function.